As you know, resistance of material changes with respect to length and area. 1 meter nickel chromium wire of different thickness is taken and its resistance is measured with the help of multimeter. Resistance is higher for thin wire while it is lower for thick wire. If each wire is connected in series, intensity changes of LED light can be observed as different types of wires are connected to the circuit. LED light is brighter with thicker wire and dimmer with thinner wire. Resistance is also dependent on length of the wire. As we slide the brown wire, effective length of the nichrome wire in the circuit changes. More length means more resistance. This can be observed with change in resistance as well as intensity of light. Similar exercise can be tried with wires of same thickness and different metals, or wires of same length and different metals. Do give it a try. Conductors are materials that permit electrons to flow freely, while insulators are materials that impede the free flow of electrons. Simple circuit is built with two AA batteries and LED, and different materials are connected in series to find out if they are conductors or insulators of electric. Lighted LED indicates that material is conductor. U-pin is metallic and good conductor of electricity, while matchstick, hairpin made from plastic and eraser are bad conductors of electricity. Try with different materials around you. Simple circuit is built with help of metal pins, wires, LED, resistors and AA batteries as power source. Foam sheet is cut to act as battery holder for 2, 3 or 4 batteries. Usage of metal pins enables easy connections of components instead of soldering. Multimeter is used to measure potential difference, current and resistance of the components. It is always advisable to use resistors in the circuit to limit the flow of current. In this case, 100 ohm resistor is used. Let's measure the potential difference across various components. It is 3 volt across power source. It is 1.92 volts across LED and 1.1 volts across resistor. The sum of these two is approximately equal to total voltage drop across power source. Current is measured by connecting multimeter in the circuit. We will remove one part and connect multimeter at that location. Current flowing through this point is 9.1 milliampere, while current flowing through other location is 9.1 milliampere. This is in line with the fact that for series circuits, current flowing through the circuit is same everywhere. With potential difference of 1.1 volt and current of 9.1 milliampere, can you find the value of resistor using Ohm's law? Same exercise can be repeated with LEDs connected in parallel. Potential difference across each LED is 1.8 volt and it is same. Current flow through each branch is measured and current flow in the external circuit is also measured. Can you guess what will be the current reading at this location? Repeat this exercise for different scenarios like two LED in parallel while one LED in series as shown. Fuses are the safety devices which are used to protect the home appliances like televisions, refrigerators, computers with excess voltage or current. These appliances might heat up in the event of excessive current and get damaged. The fuse is made up of thin strip or strand of metal. Whenever excessive current flows through circuit, the fuse melts and it opens the circuit and current stops flowing. The fuse works on the principle of the heating effect of the electric current. It is made up of thin strip or strand of metallic wire with non-combustible material which acts as a casing. This strip is made up of aluminium, copper or zinc and is connected between the ends of the terminals. Fuse is always connected in series with the electrical circuit. Cartridge type fuses are used for low voltage applications and are closed in glass container with metal conductor inside. This metallic wire in this fuse is broken as a result of excess current and fuse needs to be replaced with this one. These are places inside holders for easier placement and removal in the circuit. Fuse have voltage and current rating and are connected in circuit as per need. In rewirable type of fuse, the main advantage is that the fuse carrier is easy to remove without having any electrical shock or injury. The fuse base acts as an incoming and outgoing terminal which is made up of porcelain, and fuse carrier is used to hold the fuse element which is made up of tin, copper, aluminium, lead, etc. This is used in domestic wiring small industries. When fuse wire melts, it has to be replaced. To overcome the problem, miniature circuit breakers MCBs are used. MCB cut off the circuit automatically when excess current flows through it. After correcting the fault in the circuit, MCB can be switched on to complete the circuit. We discussed various activities which helped us to understand circuits. Try building such circuits using everyday things.